To write the equation of a sine or cosine graph, we're going to kind of do this as a fill-in-the-blank puzzle. And there's three pieces to the puzzle we're going to need to know from this problem. So the first thing that I need to know is that this trig function, this first one, begins at the origin. Because of that, I know this is going to be a sine graph. The sine graph is the one that begins from the origin. The next piece of information I'm going to need to know is the amplitude. It tells me the amplitude of this graph is 2.5, meaning it hits a high point of 2.5 and a low point of negative 2.5. So there's my A value. And then the last thing I'll need to know is the period of the graph. And this time I can see that the period is 1/2. Well, even though the period is 1/2, that does not mean the b value in my equation is going to be 1/2. Instead, I have a little bit of work I need to do to find what that b value is going to be. Recall that the formula to find the period of a sine or cosine graph is to take 2 pi, the normal period, and divide that by the b value. So let's do a little, cross-multiplying to find what our b value is in this case. So I'm going to replace the period with 1/2. That's what they've told me the period was. And I'm going to find the b value. So cross-multiplying, I find out that b has to be equal to 4 pi in this case. That's not the period, that's just the b value. So let's take all this information and piece it together to write my trig function. So I'm going to start with y equals, and then first up, the first blank in my fill-in-the-blank puzzle is the amplitude, and that's 2.5. Next up, I'm going to do the amplitude times what kind of graph this is, whether it's a sine or cosine graph. We've determined this was a sine graph because it starts from the origin. And then finally, I need to get the coefficient of x, and that's my b value. And in this case, we worked out the b value to be 4 pi. Now, don't forget, every equation needs an x and a y in it, so this also needs that x at the end. So here is going to be the equation, nice and colorful, for this graph. It's got an amplitude of 2.5. It's a sine graph because it starts from the origin. And it's got a b value of 4 pi, which gets me a period of 1/2. So there's my equation that fits this description. Okay, let's go ahead and try one more together, although if you think you got it, now's a great time to pause the video and try for yourself. So once again, it's a fill-in-the-blank problem, but there's three blanks to find out. This time, my trig function begins at its amplitude. What that tells me is this is going to be a cosine graph. Cosine begins from the amplitude and drops. Next up, I need amplitude, speaking of amplitude. So I can see from my description that's an amplitude of 5. And finally, I need the period, or eventually the b value, but start with the period. The period is 6 pi. So I've got the a value, I've got what kind of graph this is. All I need is the b value. The b value is not 6 pi. That's the most common mistake I see. Instead, remember, we have a little bit of work to do. I know that the period of this graph is equal to 2 pi divided by the b value. So let's go ahead and plug in the period we were given, that's 6 pi. And I'm going to write that over 1 just to make this a fairly simple proportion to solve, and then equals 2 pi over b. So if I cross multiply, I get 6 pi times b has to be equal to 2 pi, and solving for b, let's go ahead and divide by 6 pi. So when I do that, I can see the pi's cross out, 2 over 6 just simplifies to 1/3. So I do have a little bit of work to do to find the b value, but once I've got that, it's a simple matter of just filling in the blanks to write my equation. So my equation is going to start with y equals, and then our amplitude comes first, that's the a value. I know from the description the amplitude's 5. Next up, I know this was a cosine graph because it started from the amplitude. So 5 times the cosine of the b value, which determines the period, but remember the b value is not the period itself, and then this will always end with an x. So my equation that fits this description will be y equals 5 times the cosine of 1/3 x.